Hello everybody, my name is Zupub, and I'm about to do a artifact draft. And I was looking over... I think my sound is a little high still. It sounds high. I think it's okay now. But I was looking over my cards. I'm still about to... These are the epics I've unlocked so far. So I got Rubik, Nyx, Fractured Timeline, Whispers of Madness, Malrine Pupate. Look at this card. Double charges on Malrine Pupate. So it adds two charges. If there are at least as many charges on Malron Pupate as health... Oh, shit, the game started. All right, cool. That card's really cool. It turns into this, like, 32-33 thing with Trample. Oh, cool. It's the guy from Community. I can't remember his name. It's this pick, though. Pretty sure with this pick, I would take the Tinker. Pretty sure that's how I would play that. Straight Tinkers. Bam. Yeah, Prelix is cool, but I don't think he's that fantastic. All right, he's going for Prelix. I like that. So yeah, I'll gladly take Tinker here. I think Tinker's like really high level black card, one of the best. And I can pick Sniper or Legion here. Lady Ashnew is also kind of good. Slaycaster. Deploy heroes currently in your fountain to the first empty slots in this lane. We could try this. Let's go for Sniper too. Let's just take Sniper actually. I think Sniper's pretty good. I don't know. It's a weird card though. What the heck from here? I don't even see him. But yeah, Sniper's pretty good. Good removal with Tinker. I think in combination they're good. I might just go all black now that I have the key. The hardest places to fill for black are like your 1 and 2. Sven. Might Sven here. I would not be surprised with a Sven pick. Omni Knight's supposed to be really good. I think it seems good. Repel seems like it could be good, especially against something with a lot of effects, like a blue deck. Arc Warden sucks. I wonder if he's even considering Arc Warden. Okay, good. Alright, Mirana isn't fantastic. I think I like the Omni Knight best here. Mirana's just not that good. I don't know if I'm going to play Omni Knight. Ooh, PA and Phantom Lancer? Damn. I don't love PA. PA is good, though. I'm not, like, a humongous fan because of the Coup de Grace, but I think in this deck it works good. She can 3 or 4. That Sven is good. I like this Sven pick a lot. It's, like, really good at... I don't know. Trying to take me out here. I'm still not convinced I'm green, but the Omni Knight's really good. I need another, like, good green hero. I don't know about the Venomancer either. I think his pick is the Phantom Lancer. Unless he's trying to get out of blue. The Shadow Fiend pick wouldn't be horrible, I think. But I don't think Dragon Knight's that great. He's kind of hard to get going. Shadow Fiend's pretty good. Get him going. Who did he pick? Venomancer? Oh, and he got an Ursa? No, he gets the pick on the Ursa. No, give me the Ursa. I'll take the Ursa. Maybe he like... Actually, Farvan's pretty good. How good is Farvan? That's the question. I haven't played too much of green. I don't think Farvan's supposed to be that good. I think Farvan's good, though. I definitely want the Ursa. I'm glad he's thinking about this. I'm hoping... Don't take Ursa. Don't take Ursa. Don't take Ursa. Don't do it. It's my pick. No, it's not. He's gonna totally take Ursa here. Oh, he took Farvar! Oh yeah, we're going Ursa. See ya! Oh, we can Debbie? Dude, this is perfect. Yeah, Debbie rounds out our deck perfectly. We'll just go 1 red, 4 black. It's just a nice round out. Yeah, for sure. It's just too good. Let's go. I like Bloodseeker. Bloodseeker's pretty good. The base attack is just really strong. Alright, so... I could Debbie in the 1, but he's probably gonna Sven in the 1. That could really fuck me up. I could PA in the 2. I've always thought about doing this, right? Your Ursa? Okay. Oh, this is how we're doing it. This is how we're doing it. And I'll explain why. We're going to Ursa in the 1, Debbie in the 3, and PA in the 2. Because Ursa can take Sven. As long as I get on that stupid, stupid Sven, everything's going to be okay. But even if I don't, it's good, because I can get 10 damage, basically. Oh, he did three colors. Sweet. Gotta love it. Three colors is a horrible idea in draft, I think. We can see his whole deck, too. Alright, let's see here. Alright, so deploy left. We're doing PA. So he has no way to deploy on my PA here. And then, he's doing that, huh? And then I'm going to Debbie here. I can almost Debbie here on the creep. And that'll help me just kind of buff up Debbie and do damage to the tower. So he cannot put Underlord on the PA, see? That's the dilemma of putting the PA in the 2. It's great. Alright, quick strike is pretty cool. Deal 3 piercing damage to the enemy tower. That's also pretty cool. Alright, I definitely want to do two things. So I need to Thieving Greavel somewhere. And pillage him. Don't really know where. I don't think I want to do it here. I think I want to do it over here. Because over here, all these creeps are going to start spawning. But we want to make sure, even if these creeps start pilling up in the third lane, that we're constantly doing tower damage where we can, which we are. And he didn't, Sven. He didn't even play Sven? Jesus Christ. This should be really easy. I'm like thinking that this is going to be hard for some reason. Why would you do that? You know? Why wouldn't you play Sven? He's great. Opponent's turn. He's thinking. He's scanning through all his cards. Don't think he has a play here. So we're going to either Committed Rebel or Assassin's Apprentice. I think Assassin's Apprentice is a quick strike. It's like first strike from Magic the Gathering. So you want to use this in a fight. So Committed Rebel we can do on the tower. So let's do the Thieving Greavel first. And then we'll do Committed Rebel right next to it. And then we also have Hellbear Smasher. And that you want to put on heroes. Okay, that's fine. And then we'll do, what is this thing? Probably those neighbors have one armor. Okay. Let's just put it, we'll still put it here. It's okay. Alright, cool. Cool. Alright, so we're all doing damage. I think we all draw one card this turn. Alright, let's get 3 gold because we're under 10 gold. That way we can buy items next turn. And we're going to tinker on the creep, maybe. On the prelix. That probably makes the most sense, huh? Just right here. Go with that.
Cool. Repent and serve our ancient.
Okay, so we Venomancer on this guy. That's fine. Venomancer is a weird card. Summon a Plague Ward into the closest slot. So he's going for the creep. He's trying to fill up these lanes with creeps. Okay. Sister of the Void. Whenever an ally dies, summon an Elod and remove a charge. Damn, I can't play this guy anywhere. I could play it over here. Doesn't really help me, though. Play it on the creep, but that also doesn't really help me. So Assassin's Apprentice has quick strike, but again, nothing has 2 health around here. But I could play it in the creep lane, and that will help push out creeps. Okay, I guess this is the best play, because that'll help with my blocking and stuff like that. It's the only play I really have. But yeah, this will keep winning against that creep. And it'll push out creeps for me and kind of just prevent stuff going on in this lane. But Debbie's still hitting the tower, so that's great. Well, I'm ranked way higher than him, I think. Let's go. No actions. Alright, cool. So he is building on his creeps really well, but we are doing a lot of good tower damage so far. And we can kill the Prelix right now. Probably Phase Boots makes the most sense here, right? Yeah. 13 gold. Let's just buy the Phase Boots. Cool. Okay, so Sniper also has Assassinate. That is 4 damage. Tinkers is 3 damage. So we can't even kill this with that guy. Where do I want to put this Sniper? I guess I want to put it with the Ursa. It's weird, I know, but I think it's good. Yeah, this is good. Okay. Oh, March of the Machines is great for me here. Alright, we're going to March of the Machines over here, I think. Duel the Sniper, that's a good play. Okay. So, we are going to... Do we tinker him? Yeah, I think we March of the Machines here. There we go. And we Phase Boots the Tinker. That might work. Maybe we don't Phase Boost the Tinker, but I do think we activate our active on the Prelix. That's really the only play other than Phase Boots that we have. So we could Phase Boots the Tinker just in case, but we always could Phase Boots after he does something. I feel like he would have done it already. Maybe he has like an item card to heal Prelix. Okay. So that was the card we were looking at before. Archon Aura. It gives enemies in the lane within range minus 2 attack. And when one dies, you get 1 attack permanently. It's a pretty good card. Alright, so let's tinker the Prelix. This is where he heals him right here, right? He's gonna, yeah. See, he's holding the item card right now. Look, he's hovering over it. Oh, he didn't have it. Yes, he does.
Sometimes
oh, that doesn't do it.
The shepherd must fend off the
that
bulls.
Doesn't save you. Why would you do that? All right, let's do... Do we do Phase Boots? We could just Phase Boots the PA over, but we don't have mana for that. We could Phase Boots the PA over here, like, next turn. Okay, let's save it for that turn, right? Yeah, because we're not going to have enough gold anyway. All right, let's go. Let's see how this goes out. All right. Getting a lot of damage around. It looks like we might have to give up the mid lane, but we're almost like winning it. Oh, but we're doing so much damage over here. That's good. All right, barb mail. We can taunt right away and kill a bunch of shit. Klausmeyer might help us a lot with jamming him. Stonehall cloak might be really good on like a tinker right now, but then we can't phase boots whatever we stonehall cloak. I think we want to get the hourglass. I think it might jam him up, and we can put it on something just to heal it right now. There we go. Alright, so let's put the hourglass on the PA. I don't really want to move it, right? Or no. Let's phase boots the PA. There we go. And then we'll consider moving it. We
My
still have 6
doesn't
mana.
Have a chance.
No accident. Deal 2 damage to a unit and give it feeble. Okay. Okay. So we could do that somewhere. Oh, we could kill this creep, and that would do... No, because it's only 1 damage. Oh, we could just put the catapult... Oh, he moved everything over here. Perfect. Oh, you gone done did fucked up. Why would you do this? Okay. What's feeble exactly? When a unit deals attack damage to this unit in combat... Oh, accesses Delta Tower. Okay. Wow, I feel like he fucked this up. Alright, so let's hourglass right here.
Ooh, I like this.
Yeah, you like that. And then we'll... No accident, the underlord? Okay, they're both alive now, but I can still know accident something. But which do I know accident? That is the question. I think the Venomancer, actually. Does he have a play? Whenever an ally dies, put an Elodon in its place. Crapo. Maybe we just put the catapult over here. Yeah, let's do this first. We'll put the catapult, because I want to know accident. I just don't really know what. I want to draw out some of his mana.
We will destroy the tower.
Yeah, destroy the tower. This is good, because we're doing a lot of damage to his towers. He's doing winning this mid lane, which is going to help him out a lot. But there's nothing we can really do to jam that up. Okay. We ought to be ordered. Alright, so we're going to no accident the Venomancer, so he can't get more creeps over here. There we go. And I think I'd rather have Debbie hitting the tower anyway. Oh, proceed to combat, okay. Why is it? Oh, phase boots. That's okay. I want to kill that ward. And it's already feeble, so I'm doing the excess damage to the tower. Cool. Alright, so he won the middle lane. But now I gotta win two other lanes. And not let him win the first or third lane. Okay, get the gold. We're under on gold. Alright, Sniper has his active. So we can kill the Underlord if we put him in the third lane, which probably makes a lot of sense. So yeah, we're just going to give up on the second lane. Put Sniper over here in the Way Wing. And then we're going to kill the Underlord. Underlord, right? Yeah. We have Hellbear Smasher, though, too. But we can't do... Oh, we could just assassinate something. We don't need to assassinate that guy, but we'll just be able to assassinate next turn, basically. Okay. Okay. So his turn first. Bounce all items from caster and unit blocking it. They battle each other. Oh, we have Coup de Grace. Okay. That changes a lot. So what we'll probably do is kill this Underlord. It's going to have to do a lot right here. He might blink something over, but that's okay. I can still win in this lane, if that's how it comes to be. But I think what I'm doing here is pinging the Underlord, and then Coup de Grace whatever is my issue, basically. Because he's not doing the proper damage yet. He is getting a lot of damage mid, so it's going to be close. Yeah. Okay, so let's ping the... This guy.
You won't feel a thing.
Okay. We still have 6 mana. Alright, we're killing that then, right? Pretty sure that's how this is gonna play out. We'll just kill it. Yeah, so just Coup de Grace. Discard and slay a hero. Alright, so we're slaying this guy. We could Coup de Grace the Prelix. Doesn't help us though. Yeah, let's just Coup de Grace this thing. Alright, cool. Got rid of Sister of the Void, which is awesome. So we still have Assassinate.
Let's see Sniper do better.
And now we have no other plays, basically, though. We killed 2 of his dudes. So that should work out for us. We can also slide the PA over. Oh, actually, we're definitely doing that. Oh, no, we can't. Oh, I thought this was the thing doing the thing. I guess not. It's okay, PA's still alive. We have a lot of good things going on here. Okay, that's fine. I'm literally not worried about this lane. This is great.
Who would dare face me?
I have no idea, Legion. Alright, cool. So we have initiative, we get to pass. That's good. We can still phase boots the PA, but again, there's no real huge benefit. Other than we could get two attack over here, but...
The Legion is always
not help
well
you
prepared.
Either. Let's keep the initiative, though. For sure. Because if we use phase boots, we'd lose that initiative. You can see we're pretty dang close to winning here. Alright, let's go. Now we can phase boots over here if we need to. I think that the magicking wall is probably the best call. We have a lot of gold, too. Anything with attack is good, so the hook net might also be good. Or we could upgrade for 14. Nah, it's fine. Alright, this is cool. Two attacking items will help us poke the tower. But you can see this lane, we're crushing it. It's going to be all about this lane over here. And we have an Ursa deploy next turn. But it's going to be about moving this PA. We could probably want to assassinate the Pre-Licks and move the PA over here. That's probably the play. Just assassinating something right away. Because we don't need to, like, defend. What we could also do is just throw the Hellbear Smasher in front of the Legion. Yeah, that's fine. Oh, we can't do that. Okay, but we can still assassinate the Legion. So that seems like a good call, right? He probably has some crazy blue spell. Alright, so we could have just assassinate the Venomancer. But he could, like, find a way to win in this lane. I don't know if I should ignore this. Like, how is he going to get 8 attack here? He could, though. Or I could just march of the machines, like, here. Let's just assassinate. Slay a unit in any lane. So this is the caster sniper. And then the Legion. We're just going to kill it. Because that removes all threat.
No one is beyond my reach.
From, you know what I mean, the game right now? There we go. Alright, Legion's dead. Barracks. Okay, that doesn't stop my winning condition, basically. So right now we're in a winning condition. So I think we're going to hold. We still have deal 3 damage to a unit. But there's nowhere really that benefits me too much. So we're gonna pass because we're winning. Phase boots, okay. That doesn't stop the winning condition, pretty sure. I don't even understand. Did he just double do it? I don't think he can stop it. Or he would have already. But yeah, basically we want to react to what he does with these items, because we could play both of them with one mana. Alright, he passed. I think that's a good game. Alright, GG. Well played. Jesus. Whew. That was a tough one. That was a lot closer than I thought it would be. That creep strategy is pretty cool. Awesome. Level 41, let's go. Alright, I'm Legend 1. Let's go, baby. Alright, cool. And I got a new pack. Look, I have a new thing around my face now. That's cool. Awesome. New epic cards. Oh, we got Death Prophet. Fuck. Death Prophet's one of the best heroes in the game. A Missionary of the Queen, I think, is going to be really good. Damn, look at these cards. Choose a lane to play all heroes from Fountain to that lane team fight. Look at the art on it. Oh my god, Nether Ward, Enchant Tower. Whenever your opponent plays a non-item card from this lane, deal 1 piercing damage to the tower and burn one of their mana. Damn. Shifting loyalties. Swap one of your creeps with an enemy creep. Swap their colors. These cards are crazy. Alright, let's go. We're gonna play again. Oh man. Alright, we finally hit Legend 1. We almost have all our cards unlocked. We're on a 5-game win streak, it looks like. So let's go. Let's do it. Oh, yeah, that was pretty good. Yeah, the deck lists are pretty good. Alright, so we're searching. Let's continue to look at these cards that we have. So these are all the... Oh, there it goes. Dark Flashlight. Oh, I gotta take Ursa. Ursa all day, every day here, I think. Ursa's just so good. Yeah, we have to. I don't even know how to beat an Ursa. How do you beat Ursa? You can't. It's too big. Got the Bloodseeker. I think that's a pretty good pick. I like the Debbie here. I would pick Debbie. Other people don't value Debbie as highly as me. I think Debbie's one of the best cards in the game. I could also take the Phantom Lancer pretty happily. probably combos pretty good with the Ursa. Alright, so he took the Debbie. So we'll take the Phantom Lancer. Honorable mention to this Ogre. I like the Ogre some, but the Phantom Lancer's pretty good. Gotta go with Tinker here. Ooh. Looks like we're going black-red again. I like Phantom Lancer a lot. If it's blocked, it gets an attack and a thing, and it summers in a Lancer illusion. And they keep multiplying, so it can work really good if you kind of get it in isolation. Keep over to PA, wow. I'm assuming he wants to take Tiny here. I don't think it's an anime. This is a tough pick for him, honestly. Because Tiny isn't as good as you would think. It grows. Its ability is grow. It gets +4/+4 permanently. Axe is pretty good. I think Animage is really great here. With the 5 attack and the... Oh, Nyx. Yeah, we'll take Nyx. Sven is really good too, but Nyx is like OP. When is Animage's active come online? 3? Okay. God, give me Death Prophet. He took it. Oh, I could take Shadow Fiend. I could take Tidehunter too. I think Shadow Fiend is probably better than the Anti-Mage here. I just don't know where to plug this Shadow Fiend in. It might actually be really good in the 4. Get him better placement. Let's try that. We'll Shadow Fiend in the 4. We can Ursa in the 2. Typically, I Shadow Fiend in the 1, but I think it's better here because it's like Dota. I think this will work. Yeah, we'll Phantom Lancer in the 3. So, like, choose our spot there. Cool. This will work. This will be good. Like a bug there. Interesting. Alright, cool. Let's do... So we're going to do the Tinker and the 1. I think he's going to Sven, huh? Yep. No, he keefed. Okay. That could be good. And then we'll do Ursa and the 2. Doesn't matter where. What's he going to put here? Sven? This doesn't make sense. I don't understand what he's doing. Okay. Can almost kill that Sven. And then I'll PL here. The cleave is good against the illusions, I guess, but still don't really understand this. I could just go right on him. And we trade. That's okay. Let's try this out. Okay. Alright, so we got Trebuchets, Enchant Caster, or is it Jason? Ooh, we can almost kill it. Move Caster to a neighboring slot, replace it with a Lancer Illusion. I think we just want to get the Trebuchet out there. To do some damage to the tower. Okay, let's... Oh, shit. I didn't realize it was my turn. My bad. Yeah, let's do it right in the middle.
Here you go.
Sorry about the delay there. That was my bad. I thought it was his turn. Here you go. I got my smash of defenses, so let's go. I think this is going okay. I got Ursa doing damage to the tower. That's good. Tinker, we gotta figure out how to do that here. So we're at 8 gold. Let's just get the gold. We can't buy any items. Too bad, or else we could have saved the Tinker. Shadow Fiend. Jason enemy dies. I guess we could do that right here. Because they're going to trade. He'll get two charges. Oh, he Bloodseeker'd right on me. Alright, so we're going to Presence of the Dark Lord for sure. But that sucks,
Sax,
huh?
Sax loves me, and that's enough.
How dare you? I'm the greatest keenfolk mind in a generation.
Alright, so let's do Presence of the Dark Lord for sure. So at least we can trade with the Bloodseeker.
You know what's about to happen, don't you?
Everyone's dead in this lane, so they're still going over here. This is gonna be interesting. I think I need to march the machines over here. So maybe I'll just put the Nyx. Oh, I could deploy the Nyx. I could put the Nyx right on the... No, I can't do that. Oh, I can just do this. Let's try this out.
Perfect. One less target to worry about.
I didn't even realize I had that. Perfect. And then I get a charge. Perfect. Dude, that went well. I didn't even realize I could do that this turn. Cool. Awesome. So Tinker has his ability. Probably want to phase boots the Tinker. Or just Stonehall cloak them. Let's buy... This is close. Maybe we should just get this for the Ursa, the phase boots. Okay. I like that. Alright, and then we can Nyx. Just Nyx to the Tinker. Okay. Yeah. So if it's disarmed, it can't attack me. I don't know if... Does he not know that? Wow, I don't think he knows this. So this is going to disarm the Debbie when I just activate the thing on it.
Target locked.
So now it's
There's
not going to
no
attack
way
me.
You survive this.
There's no way. And I still have Nyx's ability, which is really OP. And I could probably kill the Death Prophet with the phase boots. He's got Sven over here, but that's fine. It's gonna... The Smeeval Armmaster is gonna buff that Sven, though. That's a fun play. Okay, got the no accident. That's good. Alright, so let's spike Carapace. Alright, I'm gonna kill that Sven. Oh, and we can still phase boots the Death Prophet. Yes, we certainly can. So watch this. We're gonna... Vendetta the Sven. There we go. So see you later, Sven. It's not going to get the buff from the Arm Master. And then we're going to Phase Boots the Death Prophet. Even though this is happening still. It's okay. We're still going to get it.
The trinkets of men.
Yeah. Now, it's not going to survive this round, but look, its armor is going to go way down. This is a good fight for Ursa. Good job, Ursa. And we can probably punch it and get the Stonehall cloak removed, but it would take off my phase boots. I could still punch it. Okay, taunt's pretty good. Stonehall cloak's pretty good. 20 gold. I think I just want to make sure I get the Stonehall cloak. Maybe I just upgrade, because all these items are kind of underwhelming. Yeah, let's upgrade. Okay, here we go. This is what I'm talking about. Either of these items are amazing, but I think I want to get this Phantom Lancer out of this lane. I'm not really sure. Let's just get the Red Mist Maul, actually. The aggression to the tower, I think, is going to pay off here. Alright, so Shadow Fiend wants to be near heroes that are gonna die. Enemies that are gonna die. I think we just go here, right? Yeah. Cool. Perfect. And then we just... So I think I want to punch it on that Death Prophet, like, right away. Oh, overpower the Death Prophet. Never mind. I'm just going to overpower the Death Prophet. Nice. That Death Prophet's going to be fucked up. It's going to have no armor. That's really good. Whew. Yeah, you're fucked. I'm going to overpower you. It's not going to help you. Yeah.
Face me! I was born to the hunt.
Awesome.
You never had a chance.
Alright, so Shadow Fiend is going... I'm going to activate his thing. Right? Yeah. He's doing a lot of damage in the middle. Well, that opens up the middle lane. That's pretty good. Still have two mana. Red Mist Ball has got to go down somewhere. We could just put it right on the Shadow Fiend, huh? So it's going to bring him down to 5 and 6. There we go. So that's 15 damage and 7 damage. He's doing a lot in the middle. That's not going to help him, I don't think. Especially because he has all the other damage in the other lanes. Does he have, like, a play here? Is that what's going on? I don't think so. No, you did that wrong, I think? No, I guess he did it right. There it is, 13 and 7. That's pretty cool. But killed the Bloodseeker. I don't think that map adds up. Oh, he has to activate. That's pretty good. Alright, so we basically want to march the machines over here before Keith does his shit. Warhorn's really good, huh? Let's get Warhorn. Yeah, I'm just going to march the machines in this lane, and that will... Oh, I could just Tinker over here, too. Yeah, so we're going to Tinker... He's going to Sven in the middle. That's not even going to do it. So let's Tinker way in the wing. He's going to Sven somewhere. It doesn't really matter. Yep, right there. Okay, we can still phase boost to Ursa and punch it. Illusion confusion. There's a lot of stuff we can do here. So, gank. Oh, can we just kill that guy? Yeah, we could kill the Keef from here. Choose. Look at this. So, we'll gank the Keef from here. Keef. That's perfect. Alright, so Keef is dead. He can't do his bullshit. My guy is still not dead.
Who's next?
Now I need to make sure I'm doing damage over here with the Ursa. And that's my plan anyway. And I have Warhorn, which could buff the attack of my things here. Warhorn does work on Ursa. Alright, so Ravenous Mass is moving around, but again, that's not helping him. So he's down to 6 mana. I have 4. It's still his turn. And I can Ogre Construct in this lane as well. If you want to do that right on the creep.
Hello, old friend.
Okay. So... Let's march of the machines here before it's too late, basically. That'll, like, guarantee we win this lane. Yeah, march of the machines is crazy. But that does 2 damage to everything in this lane at the start of the turn. So it just wipes everything. And I can still move... No, I can't move the Ursa, but I can still Warhorn. Basically, want to Warhorn... Yeah. Interesting. Still phase boots. No, we can't. I keep saying that. So it doesn't look like Warhorn's gonna help us here. Just proceed to combat then, that's fine. That's a pretty good play, though, I must say. Saved it. He's down to two. So basically at the round start, next turn, I will win this lane because I'll march the machines, unless he can eliminate that thing. It's a pretty good winning condition. And I have two deploys next turn. 29 gold. Wow. Blink is probably going to be really good here. So I can actually move something over to this lane if I have to, because I have double blink. Then I don't see anything wrong with the magicking wall here, especially because of the tower improvement. So let's go. Alright. He's got to try to win this lane this turn, which is what he's going to try to do. But I have March of the Machine, so at the start of the round, it's going to deal 2 damage to the tower. I don't think he can do this. Because even when the round starts, it's going to just do 2 damage to the tower, and then I win. See, right here, it's over. Yeah, GG. Awesome. Yo, good game. Well played. Nice. Legend 2, let's go. We're doing it, baby. We're doing it with black, red, all the way. Ursa's all the way. Look, Ursa, 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 Ursa. No Ursa this game. Alright, let's go. Alright, what time is it? 10:15? Alright, guys, I think I'm going to call it there. That was a lot of fun. I'm going to make sure to bring a few more drafts to you probably tomorrow or the next day. I'm going to keep at it. I'm hoping they add a new game mode soon, but I'm keeping at this one for now. But I appreciate it. Make sure to like and subscribe for more Artifact content, and I'll see you next time.